try to make it fit, but it may break. I don't think that'll work.
Hmm. If there's any point to this, I'm just... Nope. Ooh, a pistol! A faint smell of gunpowder lingers around the emptied weapon. I think if we just advance forward, won't that kill us? So he shot himself, and the gun flew all the way over here. Let me just see if I can get to the computer control. Maybe because I'm bent down like this. Cayne anti-personnel systems, remote sentry weapon power status. Okay, A has no or low ammunition. This one I guess is working fine. Maintenance overdue by 295 days. Replace cables leaving 18R. What am I supposed to be doing here? Active. Whatever I click on, it just brings me out. Oh, I didn't even click on anything. Okay. Well, it hasn't shot me yet, so maybe I can just go out and get this pistol. Crawl faster, damn you.
Oh, God.
I wanted to look at it. Empty. Oh, it's empty. Oh, that's right. I had one bullet. He had one bullet. What the hell am I going to do with an empty pistol? I can use the wire to jam the fan.
I think that'll just break it.
Well, yeah, then we can advance past. That's the whole idea. Wait, give me that. I want this.
Probably not a good idea.
I'm guessing this way is nothing. Let us go down here. There's just nothing here. So the only thing I can think is we wanted to remove that fan. Jam it, well. This looks like the biggest one, doesn't it? Yeah, I'm so impressed. So impressed by you. Save over in the case this thing kills me. It takes so long to get anywhere. Bloop. See, this isn't anything I can access.
Oh, God. These don't go well together.
Huh.
Probably not a good idea. Probably not a good idea. That's just crazy. Hello? That's just crazy. I don't know what I was thinking there. No, that won't work.
No.
It doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that. Maybe.
No.
No. Maybe. No. It doesn't work like that.
I don't know. I don't know then.
No, that won't work.
See, I know this is something we can work with, maybe.
I think that'll just break it.
Sentry gun base.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break. I can't see it working like that. I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
And I can't leave the way I came anymore. So what the hell do we do with anything?
I don't think this will fit.
Some Juca Cola?
Maybe if it... No. No, that won't work.
Drag the body? With the wires? He didn't react to that. Oh. So, I'm missing something. Gotta be something with this, then. Says no ammunition. I also have a pistol that has no ammunition. Danger, electrical hazard, keep out. Down here. Press F10. No, that doesn't work. Power status. So I need to restore power. That's what I've been trying to do. I mean, we've got loose cables here.
I don't think that'll work. No, that won't work.
So it's gotta be something I'm missing. A power box? Along the side, maybe? Oh, we can get back. Apparently we can get back. So I might have missed something in another room. The other room, because we can get back. We need to restore power.
Oh, God.
Or get ammunition. Maybe from the remains of the ones up top. From here, maybe? I couldn't mess with this before.
Nah, that's ridiculous.
So ridiculous. Locked and not opening anytime soon.
I don't know what I was thinking there.
Yeah, me neither. I can pistol whip the glass door.
I don't think this will fit. I can't see it working like that. Nah, that's ridiculous.
I think I just tried the same thing twice in a row.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
Oh wait, I'm gonna get killed. Hold up, hold up. Loose wires.
This isn't gonna work.
See, if I... It's not even something I can highlight, so I guess I need to get out of this one. But how? I get shot now.
These don't go well together.
This is full of bullets. Maybe I can find... I don't know. No, it's just, I'd find casings is what I'd find. Loose wires.
I don't think that'll work.
Will this just open? It might just open. Oh. Okay, that's where it gets me. So maybe the blood stains there, I'll throw the can of cola or the gun. At the blood stains. Oh, give me that.
I think that will just break it.
That would break it.
It doesn't work like that.
Doesn't work like that, huh?
It doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that.
I mean, it doesn't work like that.
I don't know what I was thinking there.
Yeah, and I tried this already, right?
Probably not a good idea.
No, no. Nope. Maybe throw it at the bloodstains on the glass. The can of cola. I mean, I think I have a good idea. It's just, is that what I'm supposed to be doing? Gimme?
No. Crazy.
Crazy, huh?
I don't think this will fit. This isn't gonna work. I can try to make it sit, but it may break. Probably not a good idea.
Running out of
ammo. That would break.
I'm running out of stuff. I've missed something. It's just, I don't know what it is. We can't go back. Might be something tiny that we can't get to pixel hunting here. I'll be back, guys. I gotta experiment more. I'm sure this is boring to watch. Oh, what are we gonna do? Pour? Nice. No control. Data line not active. Awesome. Right, so these, which I didn't actually realize, are the correspond to the two turrets in the above room. Poised to spring into the room above and eliminate any unauthorized personnel. So I guess now we can cross that room. I don't think there's anything else to do with computer control. It was just a status screen anyway. It doesn't look like we can click on anything. Okay, we should now be free to just cross.
I hate doors.
One override coming up. Shit, John! The security systems in medical are inaccessible.
Oops.
It's like they've been locally reset. I can't access anything.
Our little friend Mala. Whatever his name is. We'll think of something. Now we can. Okay, this was not selectable before. The gun is most. I couldn't even look at it. The gun is most likely for general security, though desperate measures have been instituted to control Juca-Cola addicts in certain situations. Really. This stuff is like crack or something. Oh, hell yeah! Awesome, whoa. Packs quite a wallop. You okay there, John?
Wow.
So I thought we were going to come up here, but that didn't turn out being the way I thought.
Warning. This area is off limits to all active PDT users. Please see your supervisor for further instructions.
We got lightning in here?
That makes no sense! All PDTs! That's everyone!
I know why.
Must have changed security settings. Stop anyone from heading down below.
Or coming up.
Yep. The monsters or whatever they are, the clones. Blood. PDA. The incandescence of the lightning strikes illuminates a grisly series of bloody splatters across the windows. Portal. The atmosphere of Neptune is consuming this vessel as lightning shows the way. Really? Neptune? We're heading down to Neptune. There's another PDA. Blood and tissue. Oh, we can take that. The oozing red goop contains flecks of bone and masses of tissue. More disturbing evidence of slaughter. Well, that's spooky as hell. Rows of seats all unoccupied. Gee, I wonder why. Destroyed sentry gun. You're trying to tell yourself that you're safe for now. You'd be happy to never see another tubular conveyance in your life. I don't think it's those that you need to worry about. The stenciling on this door indicates that it leads to reception. And this goes somewhere else. Alright, we're gonna look at the PDAs then. No guns destroy us. Erica Boxer. April 16th. That utter jerk. I cannot believe that asshole. What kind of a man dumps a girl on an anniversary? Poor Danica's in hysterics. I had to swap my shifts on account of that prick. Sadie made that easy enough. She was such a good friend to me. We were inseparable at nursing school until she decided to branch out into botany. Seems she's suited more to general medical research than patient care. That's fine. I don't mind. I prefer working with people to plants anyway. The new walkway in hydroponics is a bonus, too. Some of our boys like to stretch their new limbs among the greenery. Who said that the new departments were of no use? This is selfish, I know, but damn it, I've had so much on my plate. I'm having to do serious overtime, and then ungrateful turds like Eric mean I've got even more to deal with. My poor baby sister. Body of a 30-year-old woman, mind of a 16-year-old girl. Apparently he says being the pilot of the Ozymandias is just too much pressure on a relationship. As is that sweet little co-pilot he recently acquired. I've had it up to here with pilots. Are they ever not chasing tail? Well, tonight should be okay as I've got Danica coming around with some of the girls and a shipment of Martian champagne. Cool. She's looking out for her friend. Sadie made that easy enough. She's a good friend. Okay, so Danica is her sister? And Sadie helped make the shift available or something. Or she's a supervisor, I don't know. July 10th. The budget increase is proving to be a blessing and a curse. We've got more equipment for sure, but nowhere near enough space for it. If only the Groomlake was one of those modular types, we might be able to get some extra room. Sadie and I are working our butts off around here. God bless Sadie. If it wasn't for her, I'd probably be an alcoholic by now. Danica is still not over her douchebag ex and calls me up crying most nights just to talk about how she misses him. Next time I see him, I'm going to punch his lights out. I worry about Danica. She's depressed, not eating, not sleeping. I might ask Ingracia to book her in for an appointment. She needs a shrink. Work-wise, the regeneration tanks are working beautifully, but the increased demand for them means we're running short of chemical dissociation reagents, and the cell growth regeneration fluid is pretty much spent. Speaking of the fluid, it's this new stuff Dr. Malin's unit has us using. I keep calling him Mala, I'm not sure. It's technically the same as the last stuff, but I'm sure the molecular composition is different. Apparently it's 4 times as effective. It seems kind of unpredictable, actually. I've already asked Dr. Harvey to request that we switch back to the old one, which he has done twice. Why are they ignoring us? It's unpredictable. Dr. Harvey. The old one. Did I say old man? September 18th. Crazy huge brawl in the mess hall today. All the guys sweating and looking like they OD'd or something. There's been a spike in violent assaults. I swear it has something to do with the new supplies that came in. Ever since that new regen fluid, it seems like everything else is slightly off, too. I'm sure of it. Diet, medicines, genetic samples, you name it. I spoke to Sadie, and she also swears there's been tampering. The idea that we've been ingesting bad food for months scares the shit out of me. I'm going to get a friend of mine to analyze some samples. Until then, I'm locking my door at night. I'm not sure who I can trust. Sadie's been giving me strange looks, too. I might actually change the lock. Really? So something else has been going on over here. People turning violent. Ingesting bad food. So they got a different shipment of food. Unless they ate the food and the people in the crew quarters and such then knew enough not to. September 19th. I don't care anymore. I just don't care. I have to see Danica. I have to. She's with two others near the hangars, and I'm stuck here in medical. Two rifles taken from Malone and Bird and a laser scalpel. That's all we have to get there. Sadie keeps fighting me on this and making excuses. She's starting to piss me off. Has that idiot forgotten where we are? That the Groomlake is now a freaking hunting ground and that my sister is in the middle of it? I don't care if they don't come with me. I have to see my sister. I have to know about Danica. I heard her on the radio a day or so ago, so I know she's still alive. She has to be hiding. Danica was always better than me at hide-and-seek back home. It took hours to find her. Once Mom sent a search party for her, and she's been hiding at the bottom of the garden. She'd been hiding at the bottom of the garden, tucked inside a dirt hole where Dad was planting beets. She's hiding. She has to be. Sadie is causing me problems. If she won't come with me, I guess I'll have to make her come along, whether she wants to or not. Okay, we got emails here as well. From L. Musgrave to E. Boxer. Okay, that's her name. Erica Boxer. Refood Enhancement Report. Dear Erica, I was under the misapprehension that your request was perhaps just paranoia, but given the tests I performed on the provided samples, well, I have to be honest, its implications are frightening. I will generally concur with your initial theory that some batches just went bad, but there's clearly much more than spoilage at work. You have to understand that when batches like this are spoiled, they are all spoiled, not just a few. A fungus, for instance, will spread through samples, but there's an astonishing difference between the samples you've sent me. Some seem to have been cultivated quite for the qualities they demonstrate. Did you know that the Brassica sample is enhanced with a genetically enhanced form of PCP? I know this because I tested the sample on one of my rats. The poor little thing lashed out violently, suffered a seizure, and then died. The precise name is DV85, a drug that was popular for enhancing the abilities of so-called remote viewers during the eugenics wars. Laboratory-created stuff. All designer, all professional. The most alarming part is that, owing to the different genetic strains seen in the five samples you sent for analysis, I get the impression that these contaminants were deliberately distributed to both staff and patients. I'm not sure what lunatic would do such a thing, least of all on a long-haul lab ship, but I've already sent a request to my superiors at the Ministry to examine the matter further. On an informal note, please look after yourself, Erica. You were always my best pupil, and I'm pleased you chose to confide in me. I do apologize that it has taken so long to get back to you. Be careful. With fondest affection, Luke. Professor L.H. Musgrave, University of Tampa, Florida. Back. I had a comma at the end, so I had to say back. Alright. Yeah. So. Well, there's a corpse in there, too. There's, they're deliberately doing this. Check out the PDA first. Oh.
I think I found the crew.
What, this?
Are they also bloodied up, like the guy under the floor?
You could say that. I'm not sure how many people I'm looking at.
But those are just blood.
It's like something from a eugenics war painting.
Try to push through, John. A few decks below. One step at a time.